In this lesson, we will learn about two quite useful tools, divide and measure. For this purpose, a drawing has been created in advance, containing the lines, curves and shapes that are needed for the following examples. Before I continue, let's see how we can activate those tools and what exactly they do. The divide, as well as the measure tool, can be found in both the draw menu, if I open the points options, and in the home ribbon, if we click on the arrow of the panel draw to expand it. Naturally, we can type either divide or measure in the command line and press enter to activate it. Both tools create points along the length or the perimeter of an object. The difference between them is that divide separates the length or the perimeter of an object into a specific number of segments, while measure separates the length or the perimeter of an object into segments of specific length. But it's time to use those two tools in an example, so we can understand the difference even better. As I mentioned before, both tools create points, so before I use either of them, I will open the Format menu and click on the Point Style option. By opening the Point Style window, I will make sure that a distinctive point style is selected. If it's not, it's highly recommended that you change the appearance of the points to a different style. I will also make sure that the option Set Size in Absolute Units is selected, so the points won't become bigger or smaller as I change the zoom level. Lastly, I will set the point size value as 3 and then click OK. Now I will expand the draw panel and click on the divide icon. When the tool is active, a message prompts me to select an object to divide. I am going to select the line first, and then another message appears asking me to enter the number of the segments I want to create. I am going to type the number 5 and press Enter. The tool deactivates automatically, and as you can see, the points are placed so the line is divided in 5 segments. I will repeat the procedure for the curve right below. I will select the Divide tool again. Then, I will select the curve, type the number 5, and press Enter. The curve is now separated into 5 segments too. I can also divide the perimeter of shapes like circles, rectangles, and any other closed profile into a specific number of segments. So, at last, I will activate the Divide tool once again, and this time I will select the circle. In order to divide its perimeter in 5 segments, I will type 5 again and press Enter. The circle's perimeter is divided in 5 segments as well. Moving on to the Measure tool, I will expand the draw panel once more. This time, I will click on the Measure icon. Once the tool is active, a message prompts me to select an object to measure. Starting with a line, I will click on it to select it, and then another message appears asking me to specify the length of its segment. In this case, I will type 20 and press Enter. The tool deactivates automatically, and as you can see, the points are placed so the length of its segment of the line is 20 units. Similar to divide, the measure tool can be used in curves as well as closed profiles. So, I will repeat the procedure for the curve right below. I will select the measure tool again, select the curve, and set the length to 20 units and press Enter. The curve is now separated into segments of length equal to 20 units each. Finally, I will divide the perimeter of the following circle into segments of specific length. Hence, I will activate the measure tool one last time. This time, I will select the circle. In order to divide its perimeter in segments of length equal to 20 units each, I will type 20 and press Enter. As you can see, the circle's perimeter has been divided in segments of length equal to 20 units as well.